Hi everyone, and praise the Lord. This is a beautiful day that the Lord has made, and I choose to rejoice and be glad. How about you? Today I would want just to share a few thoughts from God's Word and from a text that is very familiar with us. Matthew chapter 16, from verse 13 to 16. It's a story about Jesus is speaking to the disciples and asked them about what people were saying about him. So he asks, who do people say that I am? And they gave him response. Some say you're Elijah, others are Jeremiah, some say you're a prophet, and so on. And then Jesus narrows it down and says, then who do you say, you particularly, who do you say that I am? Now that text is very, very interesting, because across the world today, the question of who Jesus is a defining question. There are some people who consider Jesus to just be a great religious man. That's all. And there's nothing more to it. But today we are not talking about religion. There are those who consider Jesus as a person who caused a movement, a revolution in the times, in the Roman times. That is politics. We're not talking about politics. It narrows down to just one question. Who is Jesus to you? By the way, most of us, we don't think up through this issue. Jesus, sometimes we try and protect him, we try and fight for him, because when things are said about him, we get offended and so on. By the way, don't get offended when people say things about Jesus. He's able to defend himself through his spirit. He's able to speak to people and talk about who he is. But the question that is very, very important that we need to reflect on is, who do you say Jesus is? When that question was asked to the disciples, first of all, the Bible just records, it is Peter who took the opportunity to respond to that question and says, you are Jesus, the Messiah, Son of the living God. And Jesus says to him, by the way, flesh and blood has not revealed that to you. By the way, before even we get to that, let me say this. It is amazing that Peter was able to narrow down and to recognize who Jesus was, a supreme being, the Messiah, the anointed one, the Lord, the boss, the one who calls the shot, the creator of the heavens and the earth, who later on Paul will write in the book of Colossians, chapter 2, from around verse 15 there. He'll say, he is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation, who created all things, and all things held together or hold together, even to date. And so this is the man that Peter is talking about. And Jesus says to him, flesh and blood has not revealed this to you. This is the point I want to say. There are people who will never know Jesus, because simply they look at him from literature, they look at him from stories and stuff like that. Until you get that revelation of who Jesus truly is, the Son of God, the one who died for your sins, the one who leads, the one who becomes Lord, and the word Lord means boss, the one who commands, the one who directs, the one who gives even purpose for our lives. If you don't understand Jesus in that regard, my friend, he will just remain as one of the big guys, a political leader, a marketer for that matter, because a man who moves people, moves the masses, would qualify to be a marketer. But if he becomes a personal savior, he becomes your Lord and Savior, it makes the whole difference. It changes your dimension. It changes your life. And I would want to invite you to think about critically. For those who are born again, think about who Jesus really is. Let him not just be a savior who saves you from your sin. Let him become Lord as well. But if you are not born again, let me tell you, it will never matter, and it does not add any value to your life. It will remain that he's just another person. Consider this, and the Lord will bless you. Father, in Jesus' name, help us to consider who truly Jesus you are, what you mean into our lives. Let us establish it in our hearts without any shadow of doubt. that you are the Messiah, the chosen one of God, who became the Lamb of God, who died for our sins. And that changes the whole dimension. We thank you for the opportunity of reflecting on your word. Help us even to reflect deeply. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. Cheers.